America is not winning any wars. Anybody with any intelligence would say, now, look, boys, we got to shift to soft power or something. We want to be number one. We have to stay out. What could we be number one in? We'll start a peace initiative. Well, you don't get no money from peace. As far as the people up in their millions, if the people think that the government cares about them, they're crazy. Now, what are we standing on? Nonviolent resistance. We'll talk about it deeper next week, but nonviolence transformation. Popular demonstrations, long range teach-ins, advocates for human empowerment, transition from where we are to where we want to go. The human potential movement, call the world to utopian ideals, utopian behavior, even utopian vocabulary. So in this stage, we talk about the new jihad. For us, it's a spiritual jihad. That's why the first thing on our writing about Oakland is jihad, but it's spiritual jihad. We're declaring war with the things that we have. We did strategic management under conditions of repression. We star-tracked them. We really did. We can never underplay how far we have come just by being here. We outdistance everybody. Everybody else had more people and more of everything. But one punch folded. Some people feel like the Dar, it fell because of this, and no, it fell because of a direct hit. And that was, everybody's on one team and the leadership is sitting there by itself. He just didn't grow up by himself. He grew up being a part of the team. He didn't have the ability to tell everybody, no, y'all ain't, y'all do what you want. This guy ain't taking on nothing here. Sorry, buddy. That's what they did to us. Their old team was in Oakland. You saw them rush in. I'm there by myself. There's a couple guys pretending to be with me, but they weren't with me. They was with the other guys. They had studied people. They were sure that once this guy see that he don't have nobody on his side, that includes family members. Khadija would, if I had family members there, Khadija would talk over and whisper something to them. And they would lean toward, and they would think that they have this power. Imagine, the government gave them unveiled power and authority to do basically anything they want, and they didn't get nowhere. Because we anticipated what they was going to do. Anticipation is a big deal. Anticipation is part of our sabukum. You anticipate through your study of history, the whole environmental circumstances. Then you study the trends. Which way is things going? Right? If you get that one decision right, you're going to be right with everything else. Basically. If you get that one decision wrong, you're going to be wrong all the time, basically. If you make the choice between America the permanent, to get in the system and help it, kiss stay behind, do all of those things, if you make that decision, Every time you come out and give a talk, and people record it, they'll be able to go out and say every forecast they made about America and its goodness and all that will be basically wrong. And if you made the other decision, if you're scanning the environment, if your analysis said, this is the historical behavior pattern of the West, this is the historical pattern of America, this is the historical pattern of all systems in decline at a certain part in history. It's like studying cancer. What are the symptoms of this type of cancer that's got, right? If you study the symptoms of imperialism, and if you study the system, historical system, imperialism, colonialism, and all the other isms, right? And we always, if you remember, it was 2001 or 2002, we talked about Pax Romania, Pax Britannica, and Pax Americana. The great Roman peace spread Roman culture all over the world. Sun never sat on the British Empire. As time went on, they began to crumble. The same thing with the sick man of Europe, the Ottoman Empire, the symptoms. We used to talk about 10 years ago, studying without a desired outcome. We study all of this, but we have an outcome, a desired outcome. That's the way the immigrants do. The cowardly people do that. They study the environment, but they have a desired outcome. They want to fit in, they all of them, okay. Now, so, in our analysis, we're correct 95% of the time because we made the right choice from the very beginning. The trends are going a certain way. Therefore, if we don't hit the target right in the center, we're going to hit the target. Because all of our stuff is pointed at the target. Because we made the correct decision. We're going to hit the target every time. Sometimes we just won't have a bullseye. But we'll be on the target. When we make a bad decision, we'll still hit the target. It's not genius, it's making the right decision, it's all. Okay. Nonviolent transcendence. So we have to, this utopianism we're talking, it's saying this is not nothing new, new worldism, living by design. The word comes from the Greek way back when, so the concept of a good place, that's what it means, utopia, a good place. We're not reinventing anything, nor of the idea. The more we study, we stumble across our ideas scattered all over the place. The only thing is adopting correct ideas for our time. And I think that's basically what we're doing. I'm gonna skip a few things and go to one of the main subjects and then I'll backtrack a little bit. Because we always talk a lot about living by design. Designing your own future. We always talk about writing the book that you want to read. And I sometimes myself a little bit, but you know, that's true. Writing the book you want to read, making the plan for your own personal development, because that's the way things have always been. If you've always been the target, you know you're the target. So you got to take care of yourself. Now, you're gonna help everybody else along the way, but you gotta write your plan, because the history has been, you cannot depend, or you could not depend on those people to act on behalf of any great principle, the principle of the good, the organization. When I left Oakland, everybody either expected me to take what I need with me, which I did, of course. Why? Because I know them. I just happened to know that they didn't care nothing about Mr. Good Guy. People are along for the ride. I tried to leave the situation where the organization, the best in the region, would continue to function. They went on about their business. Some bought the limousine here. They turned out to be playboys, and some got addicted, and some, whatever they did, it wasn't us, it wasn't the we, it wasn't the organization, it wasn't the principle we taught. As long as one of us is alive, then the organization still exists. I believe that. But they didn't. And I could smell it. Nobody even, if I'd call them on the phone, nobody say, "Hey man, this girl bought me a limousine. Nice, bad boy. But I tell you what, man, I got about $4,000 or $5,000 at that time. Imagine in Africa, $5,000, I could buy a big farm and do whatever I want." But nobody ever said anything like that. So you, under those conditions, you begin to, they're real. And you know what you're going to do. As soon as you get over, you're going to spread it around to everybody. It's not being a fool, that's just the way you are. You act, when you study yourself and you see that's my natural way, then you do that. I was showing y'all some pictures the other day when I was at the jailhouse camp, Pine Grove Forestry Camp. Everybody in there was tough, and they looked like they were not happy being there. Well, I wouldn't. I didn't sign up to go there. They sent me there. But you didn't see one frown on my face. You would have thought, that's a summer camp where they are. Right? The face. And I kept that all along. One time I took a picture at a nightclub and I looked at that face and said, "I quit." I remembered something the white man said, "What is it if you gain the world and lose your own soul?" I said, "That nigga there, whoever he is, he ain't me." And I felt like that. I was mean. We got lucky. Nobody did nothing to me for those few months. Nobody did nothing. So I still, as far as everybody else knew, I was still the same. But I looked at that, and that was the mean old white man kept bothering you, kept showing you. And I was coming to a conclusion. I was transferring from a revolutionary financial supporter to 100% revolutionary. I was reading George Jackson now, and I was reading my old friends that I just left them in jail 5 years ago. I said, "Look at the stuff these Negroes is writing." So, thanks to the Euro, now, What does this have to do with the experiences that you have? That the experiences you have relate a lot to your interpretation of those experiences. And as Sayyid Qutb was saying, he used the word that for the Prophet, peace be upon him, each level, each stage of suffering took him as though he was riding from one level to another. And in Israq al-Ma'ani, he said, you will ride from event to event. What's so important about that? And what's so important right now? There's a difference between this Sunday and last Sunday. It's been evolving, and it's been relatively clear. What's the difference between this Sunday and last Sunday? Because we've talked about I'm writing a book I want to read. I've been talking about that for a month. Actually, I've been talking about design future for years. Design your own future. Well, in this writing, we're going to write everybody into it, not just my plan. Because believe it or not, I am right where I just about figured out, wanted to be, and far as suffering, my concept was, and I wrote about it, what we're doing to this white man and how he's reacting is not a